In this short video, I'll give a demonstration of setting up a Keysight InfiniiVision X-Series oscilloscope to trigger and decode on the Scent serial bus. But before we get into the demo, let's first review what Scent is. Scent, which stands for Single Edge Nibble Transmission, is a point-to-point serial bus used in automotive applications to digitally transmit sensor data to ECUs. Here we show a timing diagram of a sent packet of fast channel data. Sent data is encoded by modulating pulse periods to represent nibble values. For example, a 12 tick wide pulse period, which is the minimum pulse period, represents a value of 0. A 27 tick wide pulse period, which is the maximum pulse period excluding the sync pulse, represents a nibble value of 15, or F. So for the rest of the nibble shown in this example, 17 ticks represents 5, 22 ticks translates into A, 14 ticks translates into 2, 20 ticks translates into 8, 12 ticks into 0, and 21 ticks into 9, which is, in this example, is our CRC nibble. Also, data fields can be grouped into signals, which would typically represent a physical value such as temperature or pressure. And lastly, the status and communication nibble can have embedded in it what's called slow channel serial data, which is accumulated over several transmissions of fast channel packets. Unfortunately, we can't go into this topic any deeper in this short video, so please read the Scent specification if you want to learn more. But I will show a decoded results of slow channel data on the oscilloscope in just a minute. Let's now see what scent waveforms look like on the scope. Let's begin by first looking at just fast channel data in a hexadecimal format. I'm going to press auto scale to automatically set up the vertical and horizontal scaling. Then I'm going to change the time base to 200 microseconds per division so that we can get two or three fast channel messages on screen. I'm going to bring up the serial decode menu and select the Scent protocol. Then I'm going to go into the bus configuration menu, which is important to set up. This is where we can define the clock period, which is sometimes called tick times, clock tolerance, number of nibbles in each message, the idle state, which can be high or low, and then the CRC format. There are two different formats, and then whether or not there's a pause pulse. Now we can use all of these default settings except we do have a pause pulse. Next, I'm going to go into the settings menu. Now in this menu, we can define how we want the scope to decode the information. And we're going to just use the default, which is fast channel nibbles, and that will decode only fast channels in a hexadecimal nibble by nibble format. Lastly, let's turn on the protocol lister, so that we can see the decode information in the lister, which is sometimes called an event table, as well as the time-correlated decodes below the waveform. Now, at this point, we're decoding perfectly fine, but we're not triggering on any specific scent information yet. We're just triggering on edges. So let's set up triggering next. To trigger on scent, first I'll pull up the trigger menu and then change from triggering on edges to triggering on scent. Then I can pop up the scent trigger menu, and we have various trigger conditions we can trigger on. Some of these are grayed out. That's because we have defined only fast channel decoding, which means we can only trigger on fast channel. We can't trigger on the slow channel. That's what's grayed out. Right now, it's just triggering on the start of any fast channel message. That's the default. Let's trigger on something a little more specific. We'll select fast channel SCN data, status and communication, and let's enter a specific status nibble, 4, and the first data nibble, 9. And now we have a very stable trigger on this particular fast channel message. So what you can see here, the status and communication is 0100. We display that in binary. And then we have 6 nibbles, 91D, 91D. And then the last nibble, 6, is the CRC. Let's now take a look at some of the more complex slow channel decoding and triggering. Here we show a much more advanced and powerful setup condition. We are now not only decoding the fast channel message, but we are also decoding the slow channel messages. We actually have two decode traces below the waveform. The one on the top here is the decode of the slow channel messages. Now, one big difference in this setup is I'm on a much slower time base range. I'm at 10 milliseconds per division. The decode trace at the bottom is the fast channel messages that we saw earlier, but because of the time base is on a much slower range, we can't really see that decode information down here unless I zoom in further, and there we see the fast channel information. Zoom back out, we can see the slow channel information, and in the event table, you can see these lines here are the slow channel, and these are all the fast channel. Now, something else that's different in this decode is we are no longer decoding the data nibbles in the fast channel, which you see here, S1 and S2. Again, I could zoom in, and we see it here, S1 and S2. We're not decoding them hexadecimal anymore. We're decoding them as signals. Now let's go back into the serial decode menu, go into settings, and this is where you can set up a transfer function, define up to 6 signals, define the start bit, the stop bit, number of bits, the nibble order, and the multiplier and offset. That's the transfer function so that you can translate from nibble into real physical values like temperature or pressure. If you would like to get more information about InfiniiVision X-Series Oscilloscope, contact an authorized Keysight distributor. Thank you.